Today's tech tip is about 12 and 24 hour cycles and helping to differentiate that. Today, I've got my sidekick Maria with me with Andersen Sterilizers. So we'll help talk about 12, 24 hour cycles, materials, consumables. So for the 12 hour cycle, as you reference back to the last video or one of the last videos that we did, metals, small plastics, smaller loads, those are all appropriate for a 12 hour cycle. And then Maria can talk more about the materials in a 24 hour cycle and if there's any changes in your consumables.
Thanks, Jacklyn. And I love the video that Jacklyn did previously about separating your items that you're gonna sterilize, like you're separating your laundry. The 24 hour cycle is your power cycle. This is specifically designed for items that would be considered gas absorbent. A lot of people ask us, what exactly is gas absorbent? What does that mean? Well, anything that retains water is going to also retain a lot of gas. So those are the items that we would consider to be gas absorbent, as well as any tubing that is over 3 feet in length. So when you have these items, you would run them on a 24-hour cycle using one gas ampoule. And a lot of people forget to maintain the right temperature, which is 68 degrees Fahrenheit, and the right humidity, which is 35% or greater. So you want to set yourself up for success by ensuring all of these parameters are in place before starting your 24-hour cycle.
So Maria, in regards to the 24-hour cycle, in what instance would you use a second ampoule, or would you ever need to use that?
That's a great question, and we get it quite often. In our 24-hour cycle, it is designed that one ampoule is sufficient as long as you are running a cycle in the appropriate temperature, which is 68 degrees or greater. You make sure that you have your humidity level at 35% or above, and the true telltale is your dosimeter. As long as your dosimeter reaches or surpasses the triangular mark, you know that all of your parameters for sterilization were met. So I know that doesn't really answer the question, do you really need two ampoules? If you have a load full of really gas absorbent materials where the bag is very full, in circumstances like that, yes, a second ampoule.
So like a lot of suction tubing, a lot of cloth draping materials, bandage materials, all of that would be, and it's a full bag.
Correct.
Then you would potentially need a second ampoule.
Exactly.
Thanks, Maria. Glad to have you with me today. That's it for today's tech tips. Call your rep if you have any questions.